good evening, guys. Hope you're doing well. Appreciate you jumping on and taking value on this call. Hope you've all had a great weekend. Enjoying what you're enjoying. I'm sure Formula One was on, and the weather's not been too good here. But yeah, Gleeson gives you a good amount of time to, you know, reset and refresh yourself, and you know, really just get ready to go again in the markets and building the business. So Simon, good to see you on. Jade, good to have you here. And Mo, always showing up. I do appreciate it there. So I just recorded a call, and then I'll send this out to the guys via the Telegram channels, and then they can catch up on it if they've got some other bits going on at the minute. But again, appreciate you jumping onto this. And if you've got any questions that you want to go through on the call, or if you've got any other setups that you want to break down, they're more than welcome to go through them on this call. Because obviously you guys are showing up, so the value is there for you to take from that, and also share back as well. So what we're going to be going over, obviously, on this session will be the trading week of 26th of July through to the 30th of July. And that will obviously be starting this evening at 10 p.m. So let's jump straight into it and have a look what we're seeing in the marketplace as well. And you know, if you was on Dan's call before covering the crypto element, hope you took some value. And you know, there's a few more hours today on the Believe Nation online event that's there as well. So I would recommend it in and out between the leadership call. If you can jump on there, take some value. It's been a great event so far. So yeah, let's just go through some setups then, guys, and see what we're looking at, you know, really for the week ahead. So what I'll start off with, let's go through forexfactory.com and take a look at this side of it, going over the fundamentals and what we can see leading into next week. So Sunday, Monday, not too much there in terms of high impact news. Tuesday, we got some high impact across the US dollar. So that is going to be on in the New York session there. So around 3 p.m. our time, got consumer confidence rate, CB. So that is going to be released. And then Wednesday on the AUD front, on the Asian session, that's going to be covering some high impact news there across CPI and some mean CPI there as well. So yeah, this is a developing process for a lot of people of understanding the fundamentals. And this is something that I'm still yet to do a lot more work on and dive into and, you know, align that with the technical side as well. But this is a starting point, going through your Forex Factory and, you know, identifying high impact news and, you know, news that actually will have a driving factor to the marketplace. Because yes, the technicals are there and you can just be a technical trader, but I'm a believer that the fundamental side is the biggest, you know, driving impact from the market there, and the technicals just line up in between that. So that's what we can see on Wednesday afternoon. In the New York session, we got CPI on the CAD, and then we got some US dollar in the evening at 7 p.m., FOMC statements and FOMC press conferences to lead after that. And then Thursday, high impact US dollar open on the New York session. And then Friday, we've got a pretty fairly clean day, apart from obviously a bit of CAD and US dollar, GDP rates being released, and core PCE. So, yeah, that's what we're looking at on the Forex Factory front and the fundamental side. So let's dive into it now. Most of you guys have been on my calls before. So let's take a look at this. Well, if you haven't seen this before, this is pretty cool. Let me see if it's going to show up. So if you look at, okay, it's not there. So if you just go straight into the TradingView website, you see they've got a really cool sort of like banner and picture that's there. So let me see if I can reset it. You'll be able to see it. So it's pretty cool. They've had an update of it. And they've got some awesome images on there now. So let's see if this one is going to do it. No, it's not going to do it. But you guys try it on your end. You may see that they've got a pretty cool, funky background at the start of TradingView. And you can see that they've done some updates. So that's pretty cool. Bit of an interesting factor for you. So yeah, let me just let these guys in, which I believe I have done. All right, cool. So yeah, starting off where we always like to start, we always like to look at the DXY front. So if you're not familiar on what the DXY is, it is what the US dollar index is doing. So if we get an understanding on what we believe the US dollar is doing overall, then we can really align that up with a lot of the other currency pairs and yeah, just look at that in terms of a bias and understanding where that's going. And that can lead on to, say, Euro, USD, AU, GU, and just all the other currency pairs which are focused around the US dollar there. So let's look on the higher time frames there. Let's start off on the daily. That's going to be something that which is going to give us big enough perspective to see what we want to see here. So if we're starting off on the daily, you know, we've got some high and some low areas which are of interest to us. You know, we got this low point down here where liquidity was still captured in the market. We've had a sweep down to that area to mitigate some orders, if you like, there. And we can tell now that we're gunning for this high up here to be targeted. We had an imbalance area in the market, or a gap in the market, which has been filled with some price action there now. So I'm still to see further US dollar bullish price action on this until you know, until really this currency tells us otherwise. I can see that we're shooting for that area. Price is being held up by these low points here now. So that's what we can see on a daily perspective. We can see that this uptrend is still within the formation. So, you know, scaling into some key areas now. You know, before we had this area open down at the bottom here where we had an institutional area, which, yeah, is still been left open, but very much what we see on the 4 hour now. You know, we can see these highs that we had up here. We had this wick right down, taking out some of these liquidity at the lows, which was at this point down here. All right, and now we've seen a continuation of price, really. So we had that snap back down. And I mentioned a couple of weeks back, and even last Sunday, that these lows here were crucial to really holding up this uptrend formation. You know, so we did have a very brief snap back down to close out some orders here, and to a bit of a shakeout on the market to give them some false hope, potentially, that US dollar would be moving short. And when I say false hope, it all depends what side you're really looking at that from. So, you know, if you're looking at, you know, potentially a long-term investment point on how the US dollar moves with the stocks and shares, then you'd want the US dollar to gain a lot of strength, which is going to put a lot of money back into the stocks and shares market. But if you're more biased on the crypto side, as we see the DXY and the US dollar rally, that is not going to be heavily supportive on what we want to see on the crypto side there. So it's always a battle in between that there. And what we've been seeing over the past sort of 6, 12, 18 months is a huge dip off on the US dollar overall. And that's allowed, you know, it's allowed a lot of money to come into the crypto side there. So there's pros and cons on both sides there, what we can see in the marketplace. But, you know, what we're seeing at the minute now, well, we're seeing this push down, and we're seeing price continue to the upside. That's what I'm seeing anyway. You know, I can see these highs easily being targeted. See those highs being targeted, and even long term, I've got this area here which we've had on for multiple weeks, and it's an area from previous point and previous highs in the marketplace that we're targeting. So we're shooting for that high there. We're looking to take that point out and then continue bullish from that there. So what can we see in an hourly? It's very similar to what we're seeing on all time frames. We've seen higher highs and higher lows. So, you know, I can easily see price move away from it where it is now. We had this massive hourly push down to move back up, and it's paused there, and it could easily just trade away from that area. You know, yes, we could have another pass down here, but we've already mitigated and pulled that down on the wick, and we've played into some of these areas in here. So, yeah, I can just see an open and a continuation on that there. And until we see some breaks and closes below some of these lower levels, and we see a bearish downtrend on this, then I'm still going to be looking for US dollar supportive buys on this, really. So that's what I can see on the DXY. And now what we like to navigate over to is definitely we like to look at the Euro USD from here. So this is something that we've been keeping eyes on for a couple of weeks now. And yeah, we've had some good trading opportunities on it. I've been saying for weeks that we've been staying in this formation of these lower lows and lower highs, which has been good. You know, I think we caught, this was created the new low. We snapped back up and we took a position off here. You know, we rode it down to some extent. And then I think I had stops below this point here, above these highs. And then price has obviously made a snap back there. And yeah, we've took a lot of stop losses out. A lot of people would have been enticed into short positions onto this currency pair, which is fine. the opportunities that are presented to ourselves, and we're maximizing them. So, but obviously, what the market makers like to do, you know, would have been laying shorts here on these closes of candle shorts, taking price down. You know, we're trading stop losses above the highs. We're moving down nicely. Stops within profit. You know, snap back to stop losses, or we're hitting break evens. You know, this is what the market makers like to do, and they're very thoughtful on where we're positioned in the market. But it's all good. It is really all good. So, from what I'd like to see on the Euro USD now, it's definitely a pull back up again to some of these higher levels, and then, you know, potentially another trade on a risk-reward standpoint. It's going to make sense on an execution. It's not great. It's not great seeing these equal lows down here. This does give us an indication that price is slowing down. It's a little bit indecisive. It's looking to make a decision on where it wants to go. But, you know, following in line with what the DXY is doing, you know, the selling opportunities are still there. It's just, you know, building and accumulating some orders, so to speak, and enticing people either way. So if I get some good pullbacks up to some higher levels and I can cover some highs, then yeah, I'll still be looking for these selling opportunities back down here. So the lower targets on this, yeah, we got these lows down here, we got this low here, and we've really covered them for multiple weeks now as well. So yeah, that's what I still see on Euro USD. You know, I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, some of the steady guys' perspective on this and the bounce back guys. So yeah, you know, I can still see good sales on the table. If we get pullbacks, then there's trading opportunities there. Moving on to GU now. So what I'd like to see on this, let's start off on the daily. So I've covered this for multiple weeks now. I've said how crucial again that these low points are here in holding up this bullish cycle. And we've had a break of that. We've had a really clean daily break of this structure here and a pull back up. So that indicates to me that we definitely still want to follow towards the downside and look for selling opportunities on this here as well. You know, if this was held up, then you know, we tapped into some of these institutional candles, we had a good reaction to the upside, or, you know, we had a brief push below to take some orders out before driving back up, then that would give me some good indication that price wants to move up. But as we've had that break in the close there, and you know, we're still protecting some of these highs up here, this would, you know, be in alignment for me to still look at sales on this here. Yeah. So what we can see on the 4-hour now, we can see that this 4-hour trend line is still intact. You know, we've had touches, 1, 2, looking for, yes, potential third touch. But just also understanding the institutional side that we may not yet fully get a reaction on that trend line, because there's more to what price is doing and delivering than just tapping off some trend lines. Well, that's my point of view on it as well. Yes, we can take advantage of trend line setups, but I'm always looking at the bigger picture on where price is going and where we're looking to target in that there as well. So, you know, really, really nice break and retest style trade, if you like. You know, resistance at the highs, support at the lows, bouncing between price. You know, we've had the breaker structure, we've had the retest now, so we could see a nice continuation to the downside from here. That will be really nice to see. You know, price is hovering around there. You know, we've got highs, lows, highs. You know, again, breaker structure, pull back up, mitigate some orders in line with here. Be good to see price really fall away from that there. If price, time and price is in alignment with that, if we look at where we are in the London Open Monday morning, then potential executions on this does look good from where it is. It'd be great to really see another push below just to give us some more confidence on bearish price action from here on us, you know, looking for some sales. Where's my fancy brush? Here's my fancy brush. So another push back down. Confirming a new lower low, coming back up to lower highs, coming in with a break retest style trade, covering some highs, trading opportunities back down to some of these lows. So that's what I'd like to see on Euro USD. You know, looking out here, Of course, yes, we can see an institutional candle up here. Does it really need to trade up here? I'm not too sure. You know, we've found a level here. We're accumulating orders, if you like, and yeah, price action is playing out. You know, it could trap some people here and make a final push up and then react from it. But let's just see how the trade plays out on that one there. Let's see how the hand sets out. So USD CAD is really, really interesting. I sat on my hands massively with this one last week, because it was throwing some people around. Let me just get back to where we was. Okay, 16th was last week, so we talked about this on the 18th. So yes, okay, yeah. So yeah, we talked about this last week, and I don't think this is something that I jumped in on, but I remember us saying last week that we seen price hovering around here, and I said that we broke some of these highs. We had to pull back down, and yeah, I was really, really inclined to take the long up, and it just moved very, very quick. And I've left these levels on here for us to go back over, and I said that, yes, we've had that high, but we also may make a return on some of these institutional candles and some imbalance areas to make a fill and another pass of these. And, you know, we didn't really get that. We had a massive push up. And from some discussions midweek and me going over this, I said that, yeah, if I was a lot more, not that I'm not present on the charts, but if I was there at the time seeing this setup play out where we're having a breaker structure there. You know, let me get rid of some of those Telegram and whatnot. So yeah, if I was there present on the PC, seeing the breaker structures there, pull back down, and time and price was really aligned, which it wasn't really slightly. It wasn't, well, it wasn't at all. You know, we've seen this massive push up in the Asian session. And yeah, just a huge rally away that just really leaded out of that, you know, the whole entire session. Asian session that evening, Monday sort of evening. And we just had a rally through that all the way through London. We hit a high point at London session. And then we had the retracement phase within New York. And this is something you'll find a lot of in the marketplace, guys. If you do some back testing on this, you'll find that direction shift depending on what trading session we're in, where we're seeing in London session that the market is going one way. And then within New York session, we're seeing the market trade off another way. So this is something that is a pattern which reoccurs. It happens a lot. And these are things that we can work out from doing our back testing and understand where we are in position to the market from what's happened previously. All right. So yeah, what happens fast doesn't last sometimes. We had the massive bullish push up, and then we had a reactive and a retracement phase back down, which of course this is always something that we're gonna get. So, you know, where can I see the market now? I'm liking what I'm seeing. You know, we've traded back down, we've traded into this IC candle, we've traded into some imbalances, we've created some liquidity here at these lows, and you know, hedge funds, market makers, and retail traders have placed positions down in. There's no doubt about it. They've seen the wick back down. They've put buying orders, come back down, close some stop losses, mitigate some more, and price is distributing now. So I'm liking what I'm seeing. It's looking really, really good. So for us to get a trading opportunity on this, we swept some of these lows again down here. So executing right here wouldn't be, you know, the most ideal thing to do, as we've had this breaker structure on the 15-minute. Price could continue to move down here. So if we're looking at this level here, this is interesting. So if we get a trade into this 15-minute IC, that would be really, really nice to see. You know, we can get a famous GAN box out and mark that out on our 50% level. All right. So we can come a little bit further down on that. All right, so if we get a trade down to that level, not straight from the reaction, I would like to see some higher highs and higher lows being created from that. Then we can look at some execution. That's, you know, fairly tight on that of a 12 pip stop loss, which is good. So yeah, if we see some higher highs and higher lows, that would be really, really good. And even if we make, even if we move from here and take these highs and trade back down, then that would be a really great, great trading opportunity to take to the upside, definitely. So I'm liking USD CAD. I'll be keeping eyes on that. You know, it's falling in alignment with what we're seeing on DXY. I've seen further bullish price action. So that's looking good. That's looking good there for sure. All right. So yeah, that's one I like. Keep your eyes on that if you do too. Let's lead it over to EURCHF now. I believe this is one I'm in. Yes, I am. Okay. So let's start on the higher time frame perspective. Let's take a look at daily. All right, we covered this for multiple weeks now. So is Leon Davis, I believe, as well. Or maybe he's turned away from this one now, depending how it's looking. You know, we've got daily trend line information. You know, we've got high highs and high lows. Price dramatically moved up. Really, really slow bearish downtrend, you know, moving down from there. Plenty of selling opportunities that could have been had. Dramatic push back down. And, you know, we traded into some of these low levels here. And, yeah, it's looking good. It's a little bit slow in terms of what we're seeing. We've got a lot of distribution there. But I'm liking the schematic in terms of I'm liking the setup, which is happening. You know, we're enticing people either side. We're building up orders and price is really going to break either way. Of course, I'd love to see that to the upside. You know, I think we are due the move, definitely. We can tell that we're due the move to the upside now. You know, we're still holding this, daily formation, which is looking really nice. So a reaction from here would be really, really good. You know, so what we're seeing on the hourly, let's break it down a little bit. So I was looking for potentially a trend line resistance support area touch. Didn't quite get it. Not sure if we will get it right down now. So yeah, we had obviously some liquidity at the highs here. And yeah, just take some of this in, guys, to a certain extent of, you know, how I like to mark up the charts and what areas I like to break down. So this is all about building the picture of what you want to see on the charts. Because if we're just looking at a blank screen, it's going to be very difficult for us to decipher, you know, where the market's going and where it's targeting, because the market is either in two phases. It's either looking to seek a certain area or it's looking to destroy a certain area. And the steady guys go on about this a lot. So what can we see the marketplace doing now? You know, we can see that these highs are up here. So we're looking for an element of destroying these highs here. And what was the area that we're seeking? We were seeking this area down here where we played into this 4-hour institutional candle and we've come down here to, you know, mitigate some orders, and we're seeking an area where we can, where the market makers can gather liquidity. So us playing on the side of that, we're seeking this area, we played into that area. So now we really want to, you know, destroy, you know, we really want to destroy all of this price action here. All of these highs are where people are still in sales. And yeah, we just want to grab all these orders that are up here and, you know, destroy this position almost. And yeah, it does sound quite funny, but if you think about how the market moves like that, it does make a lot of sense. So, you know, I'm in this trade. You know, I had some pop. I liked the confirmation of trading into this 50% IC. We had some lower time frame breaker structures, and we had some entry opportunities in that. So, you know, I'm in this trade. We had some equal highs up there. You know, the market is trading back down. If you guys want to get into this, then yeah, definitely have a look at your entry opportunity. You know, we created a higher high on that, just above on the wicks. So yeah, we're trading back down now. So if we did have a trade back down to here, or you've seen some lower time frame breaker structures, then you could have a setup that you can get in on something like this. Yeah, if you had a trade back down to there or some of these candles, you may want to look at a potential execution if it fits your trading plan and you like what you see. All right, so that's something you could be looking at. See another higher high, come back down to the higher low, and then execute on something like that. Yeah, or wait for a trade right down this bottom here. So that's what EURCHF is doing. Yeah, I'm liking what I've seen on it. I think it's only a matter of time before we get the break. All right, that's Euro CHF. USD CHF now. Starting out four hour and daily. All right, starting off on the daily. Had this bullish uptrend, had this retracement phase, had a pause in the market where we made a move from that area, we pushed up, and now we're just in this phase where we're waiting for the market to do something. Yeah, I would like to see the rally up further because we're still in this bullish cycle. So a continuation would be good on that. That makes sense. And, you know, what we're seeing in the marketplace now, you know, what we're seeing in the marketplace. Yes, breaking some of this structure wasn't ideal, but that just could be us selling off, making a retracement, you know, taking further orders down at this low. But now we're in this bullish cycle. So, you know, so as long as this holds up, this low point holds up, and we still run into target these lows, then this trade still looks good. All right. Or this currency, should I say. So, yeah. So where we are in position to the market now. Yeah, we traded into this imbalance that we discussed last week. And, yeah, there would have been, if we had, you know, seated and ready for something like that, opening the New York session, sweep back down to into this imbalance there, then we could take a really nice trade up from there. But where are we now in position to the market? Like I said, we're shooting for these highs up here where we target the top of the TP. And, yeah, where I would look at a potential entry would be down here, definitely. So if we look at this hour institutional candle, if we trade in on the open, and you know, we've got a really good stop loss on something like that where, you know, we could trade something all the way down here, really, if you want to be really tight on your stop loss, or you could give it a bit of breathing room now and see where it reacts from there. You know, yes, you know, there is a candle here that we could be traded into. I just feel like we're just pushing a little bit lower on it. Just feel like we're, oh, I've lost it now. So this one here, yeah. So yeah, just feel like we're pushing a little bit lower on it. Yeah, we've not had the reaction from the open. We've not had the reaction really from the 50%. You know, so I think we could be trading a little bit low on that. So if we look at on the 15-minute, price does look good where we can trade back into some of these areas, that 1 hour IC that we were looking at, and then the market can make its rally from there. Yeah, so I'm liking what I'm seeing. Could see phase of what, fib, low, high formation, reaction down here. Yes. It's not fulfilling all our Fibonacci rules, if you like, or areas where we see a reaction. But yeah, we could, you know, we're looking for, well, even if we see it on the bigger time frame, it's definitely going to hold a lot more weight now. All right, where we can be going low to high and seeing something that makes a lot more sense. Yeah, where we could be looking at least this 50% down into here. So that will push you a little bit low on the stop loss, but the longs are in on the open, then we're all good, you know. We're all good. So, yeah, that's what I'd like to see for USDCHF. Price is still bullish. Believe we're shooting for these highs and grabbing liquidity up there. So a trade to the upside would be good, definitely. Unless the trade plays a different hand where we're breaking these lows, we're printing lower highs, then the bias will change slightly on that. All right. Haven't marked up gold just yet. A lie, I did mark out a little area. Did mark out a little area. So yeah, what we're seeing on the higher time frames, did see this push out. We had the pull back down to retracement, broke some of these lows here, which is not ideal for bullish price action. Nevertheless, it pushed back up. And I believe we're still in a retracement phase from here. We're still within a retracement phase. We're making lower lows, lower highs, lower low, lower high, lower low, continuously. This high has still been protected with this here. We're pushing back down. We're sweeping liquidity here, which has happened. So, yeah, the selling opportunities are still there. And sometimes it's a difficult one with gold, has a mind of its own and doesn't meet all the technicals necessarily. But yeah, again, I'm a big believer that it's a good pair to understand and trade and, you know how it moves, basically. So yeah, pull back up to some of these highs. If we trade into that candle there, that'd be good to see. Trading on the 50%. That would give us a really, really great risk to reward. 25 pips there above covering that high to trade. Yeah, back down to some of these lows here. So it's a great risk to reward trade. And we know gold moves quick. So that's something to keep an eye on. You know, it looks good down here. Well, we're still creating the lows. We're having a slight grind up now. So yeah, reaction from there. Yeah, that'd be really, really good to see. Definitely would. So that's what I see on gold. If you've got any questions, guys, in the chat as we go forth, let me know. If you've got anything you want me to cover, again, just pop it in the chat. All right, moving swiftly on. GJ, starting the daily. What can we see here? All right, seeing that the trend is still going down. You know, yes, we did hold up here. We did hold up this low. And so this is good. You know, this is good for, you know, long-term bullish price action. You know, but at the same time, we're still in this bearish cycle here. So yeah, we have almost swept that, even if it was a wick. Once we scale in, we'll see that orders were mitigated down here, like the push-up. So I'm still very much looking in that, in this bearish formation. You know, we've got multiple touches. We've got that downtrend there. We've got liquidity at the highs. And yeah, prices had a retracement back up. So yeah, it's really seen a reaction from here to the downside. You know, that would be favorable. If it's going to react from anywhere, it's going to react from up here. You know, let's be cautious of it sweeping the highs. But I really think they will want to hold this area here. Because we've had multiple passes on it where the push back down, equal lows, pull back up. More orders have been flushed in. You know, push all the way back down, pull back up. So yeah, I don't think we'll get a complete sweep of those highs. Definitely if we want to hold this bearish cycle that we can see. So you know, we're close to that area where we may see a potential reaction. We marked out this institutional candle. We got that area set out. You know, it's a little bit big on the stop loss side, don't get me wrong. But we can be looking up here, you know, depending where we get the reaction from anyway. So let's see how market moves around this trend line area and some of these institutional candles. If we get the grind up and then we get the lower time frame sort of break a structure on it, where we're up here, and then price begins bullish, then we can be looking for the execution. All right. Hope that makes sense. It does look good on the 4 hour, definitely. All right, GJ to the downside. Euro AED. So 4 hour daily. Yeah, huge bullish cycle to the upside. Had a really good retracement. You know, we've whipped back down into this 4 hour IC here, which is good on the open. That gives me faith for further upside on it. You know, scaling into the hourly now. All right, let me just check this. Your AED didn't activate. Oh, man. Sorry to hear that, brother. I think I remember us actually talking about this in the week. Yeah. It's annoying. It is annoying. Yeah, if you marked out that 4 hour IC and you're looking for a buy limit on there, yeah, it would have been annoying. But it is what it is. Maybe look to go for the raw ECN account. Man, that's so annoying. Oh, sorry, brother. That is annoying. Look at that. They're really, really clean, though. Love that you marked that out there. Love that you marked it out. Got it on the hourly. Yeah, potentially this IC candle down here. Bit of an imbalance in the market. Yeah, love it. Love it. But yeah. Oh, okay. Thought I just deleted some action. All good. We'll push on. But yeah, you know, we're not completely missed the opportunity. Yes, we've had that sweep back down, but price is still bullish. It's looking good. So let's look for re-entry opportunities on it. Marked out this hourly IC open. That's a good re-entry opportunity. Stops below the low. great upside targets. Nice and simple. Yeah. All right. Nice and simple. How's it look on the 15 minute? Okay. How's it look on the 15 minute? Let's have a look. All right. Wick all the way down. Entry opportunities there. You know, hedge funds and banks into the marketplace. Price trades away. Takes out these highs. Pulls back down. Trades into this 15-minute candle. The market moves to the upside. Yeah. High highs, high lows, high highs. Now we're creating that higher low. You know, are we going to trade off this one on the open? Are we going to get a final push down? And take the market from there, basically. You know, pretty low risk trade on that point there. You know, yes, it would be good to see another high and the pull back down. But yeah, the higher time frame is there from a reaction from there. And, you know, if we get a reaction off that, then we can look for a trade. So Euro AED longs looking good. That area is there. Let's open it up a bit more. Let's set alarms on it. And we move it. All right, we're going 40 minutes. So let's see what else there is. Yeah. GA has been grinding up. A little bit messy to trade. But, you know, we can trade it. We can trade it on the support and the resistance. Sure, just, you know, high point here. Low point here. Yeah, trade the bounce on the range. Still making high highs and high lows. It's grinding up. So, yeah, trade into the institutional candle, some of the lows. Then we could be looking at, you know, an execution on it. It's looking good. But obviously, we don't want to just go from there because price is bearish on the 15-minute. We want to get that pull back down. We want to cover some of the lows, you know, even if we can get it right down here and protect all of this because some of these lows here would be crucial to still hold up to keep this bullish formation. Sorry, one or the other, we got it. So, yeah, good to see it come down to there, a little bit lower. Then we can cover some of these wicks to the lows and take a short intraday opportunity to the highs. Or if we're going to break it, then yeah, we can see some moon time maybe. But yeah, that's GA. I think all NZD CAD was quite good as well. Yeah. Yeah, NZD CAD. So yeah, you know, shooting for some of these highs again. Marked out this imbalance that we had from last week. Traded really nicely into this, actually. Get rid of this. All right, imbalance there. Traded nice into the 50%. Don't know why that didn't trigger on mine. Or maybe it did. I just didn't jump in. What time was it? All right, it's about in the afternoon. So, yeah, we had the trigger on that. It was awesome. We had a nice reaction. Price moved to the upside. Having the retracement now. We got this candle, which is looking good. So, yeah, if we get a trade into that, you know, break, retest style, entry, stop loss below the low, I'll be really inclined to take a look at something like that and at least take it up to these equal highs. So that's a great trading opportunity if we get the reaction. 1 to 7.3 risk-reward trade, you know, 21 pips. Could be really stingy with it as well, back up here on the 13 scale. But yeah, also we can obviously give that breathing room there. So good trading opportunity that's there. I'll be keeping eyes on that for sure. All right. Again, let's set some alarms so we know where we're at. All right, so that alarm's set. We're ready to go. GA. Not marked up, but very, very similar. Like to look for buying opportunities on this. You know, yes, we've had the run of this, but we've had a reaction from it as well, still moving upwards. So, yeah, potential buying opportunities. And then I don't think I've really marked out too much else, guys, to be honest. USD JPY could be looking at the short from there. I feel like this is something that always burns me, but you know, it is what it is. It is what it is. You know, it's in a good area where we could be looking at an imbalance there to somewhat. You know, we could be looking at this 4-hour IC, the buy to sell move before the downward move. You know, we've had some lower lows created. We've had the retracement phase. So it could get a nice reaction right from there, you know. Really, really could. So, yeah, I'd keep eyes on something like that. Trend line there, 4-hour daily. Yeah, it's not quite there. Yeah, AUD, USD and NZD, USD, I'm really not sure about these. I jumped into NU within the week and, yeah, didn't play out too well, which was quite annoying. I think I took the sell on it. Yeah, I think it was this area. This area in here had the pull back down, had the stop loss above here. We had the short down, didn't quite create the lower low, and then we had the snap back up. And yeah, the take from some of the steady guys and Lex on this last week, Martin gave me a bit of info on it, is that, yeah, they're wanting to see further bullish price action on this. Yeah, shooting for some of these highs up here and up here. So yeah, we could get a complete rally up from there. So that's just not something I want to jump in on, to be honest. I want to see how it plays out. All right, so yeah, that's pretty much what I've got, guys. That is pretty much what I've got. You know, we've seen some rallies on Ethereum. This is really, really nice to see. All right. Daily closures above 2K. Really, really good to see. Taking out some of this structure, pull back down, take out these highs. Then we go to the moon. So that's good. That's really, really good. Yeah. Same with BTC. We've had some closes above 30K, above 32K. It's really, really good. That's positive. That is positive. Took out these higher highs. These highs. So, yeah. Looking good. Again, oh, another buy right there would have been awesome to trade that all the way back up. So, but yeah, that's what's in the marketplace, guys. You know, appreciate your time. Really, really do appreciate your time to jump on, to take value. And yeah, have a great trading week in the market, guys. Myself and Bradley will be covering calls within the week, going over setups, and I'll be dropping stuff in the trading community group. Anything that you're looking at as the week goes on, feel free to share. Let's bounce ideas. Let's have a great week in the market, guys. So, yeah, enjoy the rest of your evening. 9 p.m., guys, leadership call, leadership mentorship call. Be awesome to jump on. Not sure who's speaking this evening. They're always very valuable. And, yeah, have a great trading week, guys. And I'll speak to you all very, very soon. Thank you.